Hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk to you about all the important questions for anatomy for first year professional exams. So I split it into paper 1 and paper 2 so that it will be easy for you to study. So on the first paper, the most possible essays of all the possible essays are, they can either ask you about a joint, an organ, a nerve plexus or any major artery vein or any canal. So the major joints which they can ask as an essay are your shoulder joint and your knee joint. Hip joint is usually not asked. Elbow joint may be asked as a 4 mark. And these are all the various joints which can be asked for an essay. The various organs in the abdomen can be asked for an essay. For example, the stomach. And then they can ask you about the prostate, the uterus, and then the ovary. All these questions, all these organs can be asked to you for essays. So most of the organs present in the abdomen, of all of them, stomach is very important. And then the reproductive organs like your uterus and your prostate are very important. So that would be your important organs. Next, they can ask you about a nerve plexus. The three main nerve plexus are the brachial plexus, the lumbar plexus and lumbosacral plexus. Of this, the brachial plexus is most commonly asked. And they can ask major arteries like the axillary artery, or they can ask you about the different veins. Usually veins will come for 4 mark. Arteries also will come for 4 mark. Very rarely they ask those in essays. More common are the canals, like your femoral canal is an essay. And then your different popliteal fossa and cubital fossa, they're usually asked for 4 marks. So those are all the important essays. So mainly joints, organs, nerve plexus and canals. So your knee joint, your shoulder joint, your stomach, your uterus, your prostate, your brachial plexus, your femoral canal, your inguinal canal, all these are very important questions and topics which you need to study for your first year exams. Moving on to possible short notes, they might ask you about anastomosis. So the most, there are four important anastomosis which you need to know. One is around the scapula, the next one is around the elbow joint, and then around the knee joint, and then around the hip joint. So these four anastomoses are very, very important. Any one might be asked for 4 marks. Then like I said before, you might be asked about the cubital fossa or the popliteal fossa. So that is an important question for your paper 1. And then they might ask the blood supply of any organ. For example, they might ask the blood supply of the breast, or the blood supply of the stomach, or the blood supply of the uterus. So all of those questions, you need to remember that blood supply means both the arterial supply and the venous drainage. That is what they expect you to understand from blood supply. And then they may ask you about the specific lymphatic drainage of an organ. For example, most important ones are your breast, your stomach. And those are very important. Liver and all, they'll ask more in clinical discussion. They won't ask more of it in theory part. Maybe something like portocaval anastomosis, they might ask for 4 marks. But the anatomy of liver won't be tested for your professional exams. And then moving on, they might ask you about any large muscle group like your pectoralis or your biceps, your coracobrachialis, your brachialis. All these muscles are very common, like your quadriceps, your gastrocnemius, any muscle they might ask. So that is very important. Then there will be one question from embryology and one question from histology. So the different important embryological topics are your spermatogenesis, your oogenesis, very commonly asked. And then in first paper, you need to know about the they might ask the development of the most common embryological question would be in a paper 2, like your midgut rotation, and then development of the heart. Those are all tricky questions which may they might ask in neurology. Histology you will get mostly of any system. So for example, like organ, sorry, not system, organ. So they'll ask you the histology of some organ, like prostate or thyroid or stomach or GIT or anything. They might ask any histology slide. There are around 45 slides which are commonly asked, so I didn't mention all of them. Moving on to possible short answers which you need to focus on are, they might ask you structures passing through the cubital fossa, structures passing through the femoral canal. Those are all possible short answers. Structures passing through the great sciatic notch. These are just random questions coming out of my mind, but any structures passing through might be asked for 2 marks. And then very small blood vessel branches, for example, your radial artery or your palmar arch. And that's an important short note, not a short answer. Palmar arch and the flexor retinaculum, the extensor retinaculum, both plantar and in the hand is very important. They might ask you about any small muscle group. Then they might ask about spermatogenesis and oogenesis, which are common. And then this is very important. The different spaces, triangles and pouches in the abdomen. Like for example, they might ask you about the trob space. And then they might ask you about Calitz triangle. They might ask you about pouch of Douglas. So all of these are some questions which might come for 2 marks generally. And that would be all. So these are all the important questions which you need to know for paper 1. So please remember that joints, then organs, nerve plexus, then different fossas, muscles, blood supply, and finally structures passing through, and all those small, small topics are what you need to study for your paper 1. So paper 2 is very lengthy in the sense there are a lot of different questions which can be asked as an essay or a short note. So the important questions would be anything from the brain, like the white matter of the brain is a commonly asked essay. Then basal ganglia can also be asked as an essay. Then the various glands like your thyroid gland and your parotid gland, all those can be asked for essay. Your larynx and pharynx anatomy is very important. Then special organs like your tongue, your ear, your eyes, all those are very important. Though they may not be asked for an essay, they're very important. Then about the heart, the development of the heart, the inside of the right atrium, the coronary blood supply, all these combined together may be asked for 10 marks. And finally, thyroid is also a very important topic. So the different short notes which you might get from this paper are the triangles of the neck, very, very important topic, mediastinum, the various openings in the lungs, the blood supply of the brain is repeatedly asked, and the different muscles of the face, like there are different muscles for mastication which you need to know. Then about the scalp, then they might ask you about the ear, which is most important is the middle ear or the extraocular muscles. And then as usual, they might ask about any blood vessel, like your external carotid artery branches, about your internal jugular vein, your dural venous sinuses. All those are possible questions. And then cranial nerves, they can be asked in an essay or short note. Then carotid sheath is another important topic. And the 4 different ganglions can also be asked for 4 marks. So these are all the possible short notes which you need to focus on. And finally, coming to the possible short answers, there are different areas in the brain, like the Broca's area, Wernicke's area, all those visual cortex. All these areas of the brain can be asked for 2 marks. And then there are different structures passing through the openings of the skull, like your foramen lacerum, foramen ovale, foramen magnum. All this can also be asked for possible short answers. And then they can ask you about the pleura and the CSF for 2 marks, the contents of the CSF, and questions will be like that. Cranial nerves won't be asked as a short answer. It's either a short note or a essay. So that would be all for this video. I hope it's really useful. It might be really overwhelming for you, like you might feel like I've covered everything whatever is there in first year, but please do note that if you read all of this, you can easily answer almost any question which they throw at you for your exams. So if you're focusing on studying specific questions, I don't think that would be a good approach. You have enough time to cover all the anatomy topics. So if you want me to be more specific and give you like a set of like 20 questions out of which 4 or 5 will come in your exam, please do like this video and comment below. If many people are asking me for it, I'll find time and put up a video on that. Thank you.